Yoga, as we all know, is concerned with the steadiness of our mind. All of us want a clear, steady, calm mind. But unsteadiness is inbuilt in the nature of the mind. We think children suffer from attention deficiency syndrome. If you look into your mind, you will see we suffer much more than the children. We are saying that they suffer from the attention deficiency syndrome. In the Bhagavad Gita also, Arjuna asked Krishna in the 6th chapter, "Krishna, you are asking me to make my mind steady and hold it. You are asking me to hold wind in my hand. Can you hold the wind in my hand?" So what you are suggesting seems to be a practice like that. Of course, Bhagavan Krishna replies, "No doubt it's a difficult practice, but through abhyasa and vairagya, that is practice and detachment," these words are mentioned by Patanjali in the sutras. "Through practice and detachment, it is possible. It is in your hands." This is the greatness of the Yoga Sutra, because it always says we are responsible for our actions and we are caught up by our actions, and it is our actions that can lead us to that state of freedom. We are responsible for it. The first chapter of the Yoga Sutra also says, what is the cause of unsteadiness of this mind? They list 9 factors or 9 causes that are responsible for the unsteadiness. In Sanskrit, they call it vikshipta chitta, and a distracted mind. The first one, as many of you may know, is the vyadi or the disease. It is the first chapter, 30th sutra, if I am right. The disease also disturbs the mind. The second one is sthyana. Sthyana is the mind by nature is very hyperactive. And when the mind is hyperactive, naturally there is unsteadiness. Then doubt, samshaya. The samshaya or doubt is like the swing. When you want to take a decision itself, the mind is unsteady. That is the reason. You see, we constantly take decisions. Without taking decisions, nothing is possible. We are not aware of it, but we are taking decisions. You simply even to open the door, close the door, etc. So therefore, there is a fluctuation that is in the mind, in this even decision-making process. So, and sometimes here, samshaya is used whether you want to decide whether I should do this or whether I should not do this, whether I should want to go in this direction or in that direction. Then the fourth one in this list is called pramada. This Sanskrit word pramada is absence of mindfulness. This absence of mindfulness is the root cause of all these 9 obstacles or impediments or the causes of the disturbance of the mind. If this absence of this mindfulness is overcome, the other factors will automatically fall into its place. That is, the other causes can be removed. Pramada, because the next one you will also see, vyadhi, sthyana, samshaya, pramada, alasya. Alasya is sluggishness. Then avirati. Avirati is temptation. That is absence of control over the senses, the functioning of the senses. You will find this is a very important impediment that can be overcome by pramada or absence of mindfulness. That is, we should have mindfulness. Therefore, they say do not have absence of mindfulness. Then, you know, The three more are listed in terms of illusion, delusion, confusions and all that. So these three, in fact, are for more serious practitioners. On the path to freedom, people getting confused. But whatever these causes are, the most important, the foremost factor that causes unsteadiness of the mind is Prabhada. Therefore, it should be overcome. If this is overcome, the mind becomes steady. That is why it is given most importance right from the Upanishads and the Yoga Sutra also. We will look into it, because today I am going to talk about the philosophy or behind the mindfulness. What is the philosophy behind the mindfulness based on Yoga Darshana? And also where it is mentioned in some of the Upanishads.